In this demo, we'll take a look at machine learning services built into SQL Server, but in this case, we'll be doing it on Linux. So let's start here, and we'll do a simple example using the Iris dataset to train a model and then score the data against the model. So here I have a SQL file that has some commands in it that we're going to run, and I'm connected to a SQL Server running on, as you can see here, Linux. So this was new. We've had machine learning services built into SQL Server since SQL Server 2016 when we introduced R inside of SQL Server, so you could use R to train models and sort of build out these machine learning models using the R language directly inside of SQL Server. In SQL Server 2017, we added support for Python, but up until now, it's only been available in SQL Server on Windows, and that's the new thing that we're adding here is now we have the ability to run machine learning services on SQL Server on Linux. So let's just create an empty database that we're going to use to kind of bring our data into. We can then create a model over that data, and then we can score the data against that model. So now we'll create a couple of tables inside of there where we're going to store some data about the iris flowers. You can see here we have some columns for storing the sepal and the petal length and width and the species ID and species name. And then we'll create another table where we will store the model that we produce. Now what we're going to do is we're going to create a store procedure which will be used to get the iris dataset. And in this case, we're getting the iris dataset from an open source project where they have some learning data that you can get. And this is kind of a convenient thing where because we've provided a bunch of Python R libraries in the box, you can easily go out and get data sets from these public data sources and bring them in and use them for training data and just kind of experimenting with things. Now, in this particular example, we're going to get the data from this external data source, and then we'll use pandas to load the data into our table. So let's go ahead and create this store procedure here. And now we will just use this store procedure we just created to insert the data from the public data set into the local table here inside of our test database. And we can see that we now have those 150 rows populated into here. Here's the first 10 rows of data that you can see here. That shows the sepal length and width and petal length and width and the species of the particular iris and the species ID. So next we're going to create a store procedure which will be used to create the model using the naive Bayes algorithm. So you can see here, in this example, we're using sp execute external script to execute a Python script. And you use sp execute external script in the same way to execute R scripts as well. And we're doing this in the context of a stored procedure inside of SQL Server. And you can see that here we can import libraries like Pickle. In this case, we're also importing the Gaussian naive Bayes algorithm library as well. And then we can use that to train the model. And we do this by selecting the data out of our flower table that we had, the iris table. And then we're going to output the model and convert it to a var binary max and store it in our model table that we just created a minute ago. So let's go ahead and create this store procedure. And now let's generate the model and store that model into the iris models table. So you can see that it quickly goes through that data set, produces a model, and you can see the binary representation of that model here, and we store it back inside of SQL Server. So what's interesting about what we're doing here, right? Think about it. We've brought some data inside of SQL Server, and we've used a Python script using a library provided as part of SQL Server to train the model using the naive Bayes algorithm. Once we've produced that model, we store that model right back inside of SQL Server. So this is a little bit different than the normal pattern that data scientists use. Normally, data scientists will extract the data out of a database, bring it to some machine learning server, or maybe even their laptop or desktop, and they'll train the model there and produce the model there on that machine learning server, that desktop or laptop. And that's really not ideal because you're, first of all, having to move the data around, you're creating copies of the data, and it really becomes potentially a security issue. You have the, if somebody's trying to train a bunch of data on a laptop, that may not be that powerful of a system. Here we're using the full power of the underlying hardware that a SQL Server might have with lots of memory and disks and things like that to be able to process this data quickly. So now that we've produced the model and stored it right back inside of SQL Server, we can actually use that model to score against the data that we created before. And so here we're going to create a new stored procedure called predict species. And this will use the same data that we have, but then run it through and score it against the model that we have. And we can actually sort of use this as a way to test the model that we've produced. So let's go ahead and create that stored procedure. And now we'll execute that stored procedure. And we'll see that the output of this is going to show us the actual species ID that was imported by the data set, and then the predicted species ID by the model. And you can see here, if you just kind of scan down this, that for the most part, we're pretty accurate, right? There may be some deviation here where we didn't accurately predict, like this example. But for the most part, it looks like we're probably, you know, 98% or so accurate with our predictions using the naive Bayes algorithm. So next, let's take a look at an example of using SQL Server to predict the hospital's length of stay for an incoming patient. So to do that, let's first just start up an application that sort of represents maybe an application that maybe a nurse at a hospital would use to intake a patient into the hospital. And the nurse maybe wants to predict, based upon the user's vital signs and that sort of thing, how long the patient will be in the hospital. So we can just fire up this web application here, and we can click on the patient, and we can see maybe some of the statistics about sort of lab results, the vital statistics in terms of the patient's age and weight and BMI and so on. And based upon this data that has been captured about the patient while he's been there at the maybe emergency room or something like that, we can use that data and score it against a model to predict how long we anticipate that particular patient will be in the hospital. We can see here that Anthony is projected to be in the hospital for about 3 days. So how did we determine this? This is actually determined by calling a stored procedure inside of SQL Server from the application here. And let's take a look at what that stored procedure looks like. The stored procedure is called admitPatient. And the admitPatient stored procedure takes like a bunch of data about the particular patient, you know, and certain sort of like their vital signs and that sort of thing. And then using the Python language here and the random forest model, we can actually predict how long that patient will be there. Now, in this particular case, we can see down here that we're using the predict function inside of SQL Server. And this is a new function that we've introduced in SQL Server that allows you to just, from the context of T-SQL, use a predict function and pass in the model and the data, and then it will output a predicted value, in this case, the length of stay. And then in this particular case, we're just inserting that data that came back from the execution of this stored procedure and scoring against the model into a length of stay table, just for sort of record keeping purposes. We can go back and look at over time that data and see, kind of compare the vital signs versus the predicted length of stay. And then we can just return back the results, including the length of stay, as a result from this particular stored procedure. Now, what might be interesting here is like, well, where did this model come from, right? So this model actually comes from a table where, you know, we're storing that particular model in binary format, similar to what we just saw with the length of stay demo, right? So we can just kind of pop in here and do select star from length of stay models. So we can see here that we have a bunch of different models. In this particular case, we're getting the Python-based random forest model, and we can see the binary representation of that model here. Now, the next thing that we might want to do is to take a look at how that model was produced, right? So in this case, we have another stored procedure called PyTrainLengthOfStayModel. And here we're, you know, similar to what we saw with the Iris model training stored procedure, we're getting a bunch of data out of the database about past patients that have been in the hospital and their particular stats. And we're then using a Python library here to, you know, go ahead and predict how long we expect that person to be in the hospital for, using the random forest function inside of the Python library that we're using here. Now, this allows us to, you know, sort of predict using that source data how long we expect people to be in the hospital for. We produce that model, we store it right back into SQL Server in that table, and then we can call up that model and use it using the predict function as part of another stored procedure that's called from the application when we want to admit a new patient into the hospital. So this is a really cool demo of just kind of a real-world application of being able to use a lot of data that you may have laying around to actually apply machine learning to that and have some predictive function that can be useful in sort of predicting your capacity at a hospital, for example. So thanks for watching.